What's going on, everybody? My name is Chris the Chaos Gamer, and welcome back. I need to move myself over a tad bit. Welcome back to Pokemon Snakewood. In the last episode, we got through the maze, finally, and we're now at a place called the Boss's Garden. So maybe we'll be finding something here that we could use? or not something we could use to progress the story a little bit. Also in the last episode, we went and caught a new Mon to be in our party. We have Gary the Slugma, who apparently has Flame Body, which is very nice. So while we're here, let's do a quick team recap. So first we have Maya, our Gyarados, level 29, with Intimidate, holding the Gamblefish, which is very nice because we need, because money. Rockin' in Splash, Tackle, Bite, and Surf, and I actually don't know the next time Gyarados actually gets a level up move. I should probably look it up between this and the next episode, unless it learns one now. Next we have Poik, our Ball Toy, level 33 with Levitate, with holding the Demon Horn, which is the same thing as the Quick Claw, with Psybeam, Harden, Rapid Spin, and Ancient Power. Next is Dega, our Mystery Egg, level 23, not holding an item though, but with Shell Armor, so it won't have, so won't take any critical hits, which is nice. If this was a Nuzlocke, it would be nice. With Arden, Leech Life, Tackle, and Egg Bomb. Next is the Puku, our Nuzleaf, level 34, with Early Bird as its ability, holding the Leftovers with Bite, Faint Attack, Cut, and Fake Out. And our new Pokemon from last episode, Gary, our Slugma, with Yawn, Ember, Rock Throw, and Harden, which is actually not a half bad moveset, especially Yawn. Ember, I'll see if we have any better Fire-type moves. I don't think we do, but I'll check anyway. He also has Flame Body, which is burning on contact, which is nice. But he's not holding an item yet because we literally only just got him. So that's the team right now. Before we move ahead, I kind of feel like I need to... must be something. I could give it Sunny Day. I could. I don't think I'm going to quite yet. If I do need to, I will. We need to heal the party up. I don't know if they're gonna have a, don't know if there's gonna be a bag here. Something else, too. In between episodes, in between the last episode and this one, I was fiddling around with the audio levels a little bit, on my recording software. So, if you guys find either the game audio or the, or my voice is a little bit too loud or too quiet, let me know, and I'll have it fixed up during my next recording session. I'm also recording these, two weeks in advance, because as of recording this, I'll be, because this is the 8th of, this is the 6th of August, and, which is on a Sunday. This coming weekend, I'm not gonna be able to record, so I'm doing some bulk recordings right now. And I need to record 4 videos today. I did 3 yesterday. So this episode is going to be the Friday in which I will be back, but I like to do a week ahead in recordings. So let me know, either on Twitter or as a comment. Let me know. Just let me know if either the gameplay or my voice, or both, is either too loud or too quiet, and I'll try and have it fixed up for the next episode. But I was doing some test recordings before this, and I think the audios are pretty good now, but I would like to know for sure. And my hair, oh my lord. My hair is like having a bad hair day. Hold on. There we go. A little bit better. Let me just see. Yeah, a little bit better. Yeah, so just let me know, and then my next recording session, I'll fix it all. Either which way, We're gonna save because I feel like we're about to do a boss battle, especially since we're in a place called Boss's Garden. And we are also going to put our new Gary to our to the top of our party. All right, let me see if there's anything else I can do. I can't run, so technically we're still inside of a building. We'll hop down here. Can we go? We can go across here. There's a lot of caves. It looks like that is where we are supposed to go, but I feel like that there should be a hidden item here. I really do. I really do feel like that there should be a hidden item, but I guess not. Alright, I tried. And I don't know why that cave is there. I really don't. But okay, let's go in. See. What do we got? Oh. Okay. Okay. What? Give back Lisa's Poke Gear? No way! I need it for my research, plus I get control of his Pokemon this way. In fact, let me demonstrate. Complete voice change. So this is Dr. Malfeasance? He has a Haunter level 29. Okay. Haunter goes. Do I have a dark? I do have a dark move with Maya, actually, which is very nice. Let's do it. Maya or Gyarados putting in the work, plus we get the Intimidate drop, which is nice. Shadow Punch. I was gonna say that shouldn't be doing too much damage, and he's cursing. I think curse goes away after you switch. So if this body takes it out, which it doesn't, I need to switch. You know what? Let's switch into Daga. Daga needs some level up. Because I don't think curse works if you switch. No, it doesn't. The only move we could use on it is Leech Life, so why not? Is cursing itself again? Okay. That's fine. Cut its own HP in half, killing itself. And Daga's not going to be in there for much longer anyway. What's next? Quillfish. Yes, I will change. Quillfish being water poison. Poik will not be. Seppuku technically would be a good option. Yeah, let's bring out Seppuku. Because we can fake out. As long as it doesn't have poison touch. So we'll go fake out. I just realized Seppuku is at 100 HP, which I believe right now is the highest of everyone. Yes, the next closest is Maya, which is still like just about 10, like 15 levels on, or 5 levels under, which is hilarious. Okay. We got the flinch, which it did pretty, alright damage. I don't want to send out Gary. Let's send out Poik, because I believe, if I remember my types correctly, Psybeam should be super effective. If I'm remembering this right. And it is. Alright, cool. You have Ice Beam. Fair enough. And you're faster. No, it must be in a speed tie because I used Psybeam first last turn. Okay. So that was a speed tie, which is alright. Let's go back out to Seppuku. Do another fake out. And it doesn't look like you have poison touch. Unless it hasn't activated yet. I forgot what Feint Attack does. Let me just double check Feint Attack. Draws the foes close and strikes without fail, 60 power. Okay, so it's basically a dark type quick attack. Let's do it. Surf? Ha! That won't do anything to Seppuku. Come on. You should have used Poison Fang. That would have done more damage. Face Leech, here we go. I don't know how Face Leech works. I'm gonna send out Gary. Just to be sure. I want to say Face Leech might be grab part grass. So let's try Ember just to see. And he confuses me. Please do not hit yourself. Thank you. Normal damage, but oh boy. Half HP on a Mon that is 12 levels under. Gary, what's your special attack? What is your stats? Special attack 38. Jeez. Alright. Let's do another Ember, since we know... Oh, flinched. Man, Gary's putting in the work. There's a bite. Don't flinch me again. Two flinches in a row. Come on. That's three stages now. Ooh. I had a feeling that was gonna kill eventually. Let's end out Seppuku. And... Man, that speed boost. It's definitely faster than everything on my team right now. So let's go fake out. Nice! Very nice, Seppuku. Very, very, very nice. That experience. Kadabra. Yes, I will change. I will change over to Maya. Because we have Bite. Bite is dark. And Alakazam is psychic. Alright, we get the Intimidate drop. Although, unfortunately, Kadabra is special. And let's go Bite. Give me knock off. Okay. That's fine. We got Bite. Barrier? That raises defense. Shoot. That's not gonna do much now. Okay, keep using Barrier, that's fine. As long as you don't hit me, that's fine. I won't complain. One more. That's all we need. Just one more. Alright, we got this. We got this in the back. I don't know. Alright. Bye-bye, Kadabra. Alright, what do we got? 1,024 experience? Not bad. We got a gig of experience. Even Gleese's powerful Pokemon couldn't beat you. Damn right. I know, I failed because Gleese's Pokemon will only obey their true owner. I guess I have no choice. Here, take the Poke Gear. Alright. Might as well have this too. After all, you've legitimately defeated Watson. Oh, okay. The badge? Yeah. We got the Dynamo badge. Cool. So that basically this entire... Now get out of my sight. This entire time... was... basically a gym battle. Alright. I think it was this way we went. I think it was this way. Here's another Slugma, which we don't need. Alright. Too bad I don't have another Repel. Repels would be pretty nice right about now. Another Slugma? Okay. Alright. Level 29. I could have had a level 29 Slugma. Alright. Oh my god. Homebone. We don't need a rock type. I don't think we do. Well, we got five Pokemon on our team, which is not bad. Oh my god, there's so many Pokemon in this cave. I get it. We have Homebone and we have Slugma's living here. I get it. I'm pretty sure it's down I'm supposed to go. Yeah, here it is. Hello, Gleece. We have saved you. Splendid, you got back my Poke Gear. Now let's go. Activating. Did you hear that? What? I can't hear anything. It's the Inquisition. I feel their presence disturbing the Tau. Listen, I'll teleport you out of here with my Poke Gear. I think I'll have a little fun with these vermin now that Face Leech and I are reunited once more. But before I do, please take this as thanks for helping me out. HMO6. Yes, yes, now go. Your Pokemon look like they've had more than enough of the Inquisition. And we're outie. Okay. HMO6 is Rock Smash. Was there a place that I needed to Rock Smash before? I don't remember. I remember there was a place I needed, I needed Cut before, but I have that now. I'm just trying to think if there was a place that I needed Rock Smash for. I don't think so. Alright, we got that. Okay, we still got Gary in our front, which is nice. What do you gotta say? You don't say anything. We could go this way. That way leads towards Lilico. Or no, Fortree. North leads towards Lava Ridge and Folibor. I need to remember my Hoenn. We also have Mount Chimney up there. We also got Blighted Way, Famine's Desert, which is literally just north. And we have the Shakya Monastery. The Weather Institute is up this way as well, I believe. It's like somewhere along Route 119. We also got Lily Cove, Zootopolis Heights, Fort Draco, and of course Everground City and Zootopolis. Pacific Log. We've been to Slateport. Vernon Turf Ruins if we go to the right. Or go to the left. We can try. We got Route 115, Rustboro, Route 114. Alright, you know what? We only did one battle so far, so let's do another. Can we talk to you guys? No, you guys are too busy battling. If I remember correctly, there was like a single guy here who's no longer there. Alright. I guess we'll talk to you. You know, it's cool to have Pokemon battles and stuff, but if your Pokemon gets hurt, you have to nurse it back to health. Okay. Game Corner has no one there, I know that. Route 117, we can head towards Folibor Ruins. We can leave Pokemon here at the daycare. The Pokemon that protect me, so I'm caring for them. If you'd like to have your Pokemon raised, have a word with my wife. Have a word with my wife. Alright, let's do this route. There isn't really much to this route, so let's do it. And another key. These chefs, man. Haroi K sends out Munchlax. See how much Ember does to a Munchlax. Oh, jeez. Alright, not doing that. Amnesia, special defense. That's fine. We're gonna swap out to Maya. I'm actually kind of glad we finally have a fire type. That was something we needed, I think. Screech. That lowers my speed. Defense. And we'll go Surf. See how much this does. Ugh, alright. Can you stop lowering my defense? Thank you very much. Let's see how much bite does. Oh my god, Mark, bite does nothing. This better not. Okay. I'm pretty sure every time Lick has 100% paralyzed me every single time. Why? Then, of course, the chef uses a Gateau. I'm just trying to think what to do. You know what? I'm going to swap out to Seppuku because Seppuku can do Fake Out. And if I remember correctly, Fake Out did a nice bit on Munchlax before. I think. The fact that it keeps doing its special defense as well is kind of, there we go. There we go. Let's do the cut. Cut kills. Alright. Cut kills. Gary, Seppuku, and Maya. Another Munchlax. Yes, I will swap. I will swap out for Gary again, because Gary needs the levels. I think if I remember correctly too. Oh my god, he has 6 mods. This is gonna be a while. You know what? Let's put you to sleep. Lick, that's gonna paralyze. Got the burn. You know what? Gary's gonna do this one all on its own. Let's do Rock Throw. Oh my god, never mind. I'm taking him out of there. Because this isn't gonna be doing much. Although the poison does help. Or the burn, sorry. You know what? Sure. Oh my god. Does nothing. Hurt by the burn. Burn takes him down to just less than half. Rock Throw does more damage than Ember. There's the paralyze. I was wondering when it was going to happen. Alright. Oh my god. Now I'm missing? Seriously? Alright. Let's do Rock Throw again. Lick is doing nothing. That was a crit, though. Doing not a lot to me, so I'm not, ooh, another Munchlax, Jesus. Alright, let's send out Seppuku. Seppuku can take these guys out rather quick, so let's do that. Alright, let's go Fake Out. And let's go Feint Attack. Screech. Screech does nothing. Feint Attack again. Oh, excuse me. Let's do one last Feint Attack, just because. And there we go. Seppuku should get... I was going to say, should get a nice bit of experience from that. We're also going to swap out to Gary again. Because once again, Gary needs leveled up, level ups. I also need to double check what level Slugma evolves. Man, these Munchlaxes, though. I'm going to double check right now, actually, since I'm here. Oops. Slugma. Oops. Alright. Slugma evolves at level 38. Okay. Not too bad. That's not too bad. Basically about 14 levels. Yeah, 14, so he's at level 24. It's gonna take a while, but Slugma is doing pretty good so far, regardless. Don't you dare. He swallowed, oh my lord. Alright. Let's do Feint Attack again. And not enough quite for a kill. Spooku should definitely get a level. Should definitely get a level up after this, though.
Should.
Man, we are already. That was a crit. A useless crit. So Spooku level 35. Here we go. Curlia. Yes, I will change. Let's change to Maya. Because Curlia is a psychic type. And we all know what happens to psychic types when you bite it. I think that confusion shouldn't do much. Nah, it did nothing. I was gonna say bye bye Curlia, but geez, alright. Calm mind, we got this. As long as we're not fully paralyzed, we got this. And we're fully paralyzed. That confusion, again, is not going to do much. Don't. Not only are we paralyzed, but we're also confused. Do not hit yourself. Maya? Please. Do not hit yourself. Alright, I'm taking you out of there. I'm taking you out of there, putting Spooku in, faking you for the kill. This is... I think Curlia's or I think this is the last one. Because Curlia always seems to be the last one that they send out. Maya level 30, very nice. Trying to learn Leer. Why? No. Don't want to learn Leer. Oh. We have another one. Okay. I have a good old tasty feigned attack for ya. That should do a nice bit of damage. Kills in one hit. Very nice, Spooku. 840 experience. Down goes Haruhi. And then he should crumble into dust. No, he just straight up fled. We'll pick up these berries, and we'll end off the episode. I just said episode almost like I was British. Episode. And yeah. So, I'm gonna leave things off here. I forgot what Wepper Berries does. Just give me a second. I forgot what these berries do. Wepper Berry. Pokeblock ingredient. Oh, it's literally just a Pokeblock ingredient. Alright. We actually have a nice bit of, we got three berries, that means absolutely jack. But the rest are alright. And we got a nice bit of it. So, I'm gonna end things off here. In between episodes, I'm gonna heal up, and we'll start right back here at Route 117. If you guys enjoyed the video, be sure to click up that thumbs up button, like you never clicked it before, and subscribe to the channel for more videos like this one. I've been Chris the Chaos Gamer, and I will see you in the next one.